If you ever seen a one-trick pony in fields so happy and free.
Darren Aronofsky's new film, The Wrestler, tells the story of Randy the Ram, a professional wrestler facing middle age, his broken body, and his estranged relationship with his daughter.
If you've ever seen a one-legged dog, then you've seen me. Then you've seen me.
It's interesting that it focuses so much of its, so much of the body of the film on what happens when you're no longer young enough. And, you know, it's got Mickey Rourke and Marissa Tomei, who are not what you would characterize as old, but for their profession, it focuses on how they don't seem to fit anymore.
Sure.
It gives the film this kind of, this genuine sadness.
Mm-hmm.
But it does something more, too. It's actually, instead of being a largely depressing film, you know, a largely sad film, it is instead, it has a sense of humor about it.
Sure.
And it's not preoccupied with, you know, focusing exclusively on how broken and empty these characters are, but how they simply are doing what they know how to do.
I used to try to pretend that you didn't exist, but I can't. You're my girl. You're my little girl.
Did you notice how grungy the film looks? Like, I remember when he's in the bathroom and, you know, he's griping about the name tag, how uncomfortable I felt, just how, you know.
Yeah, it's the whole movie has the kind of visual motif of a VFW hall bathroom.
Sure, sure.
You know, it's just
you can smell it.
Exactly. Everything smells like vaguely of urinal cake.
Mm-hmm.
So it's and it is
like the legend signing.
And that I think adds to
the
verisimilitude that makes it seem very real. And it's a very intimate film, but you're never in Mickey Rourke's point of view.
Mm-hmm.
The wrestling sequences are. You're in there in the middle of the ring, and you're kind of trapped with these guys who are not just going at each other with their bodies, but with staple guns and ladders and glass doors and
barbed wire. Trash cans
and barbed wire.
Prosthetic legs.
And prosthetic legs. It was so thrilling, and it was so overwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that the crowd was a really interesting supporting character in this because
they
almost act as if they're like a single organism, right? That they're they chant, they relate, they have these dialogues in chant form with the wrestlers.
And it speaks about the charisma of these wrestlers that they're able to do that to get those crowds of people to you know get on board with them. That I think that's really a talent, and it's amazing that that happens. There's this hang up that it's fake, that there's no real competition, and it's interesting because professional wrestling is staged, the outcome is staged, which means that
it's somewhat choreographed.
Exactly, but the actual pain that goes through it, I mean, that's all genuine. They really go through these, you know, sheets of glass and thumbtacks and staples.
Mm-hmm. So I think that the film is actually more than you know, how it's being publicized. It's more than just a showcase for Mickey Rourke.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually kind of an interesting and important exposé, you know, into this privileged space of professional wrestling.
Hey, man. How you doing, man?
Hey, Tommy. I'm going to be working tonight.
I know you, Tommy. I saw you out in Pennsylvania a couple months ago.
Allentown.
You're really good. You really brought it.
Thank you.
Keep working, man, you know.
You're in areas of limited access with this film, which, again, I think is really interesting and also rewarding. So, yeah, I mean, you know, at the very least, it's an entertaining film, but at the same time, I do think it is a thought-provoking film that it makes you really think about not just professional wrestling, but culture in general, you know, that you'll come out of the theater. Why is that? What is this saying? So I think it's definitely worth the ticket price, at least. And The Wrestler will be playing at the Athena this week.
Thanks a lot. This has been Real Time. So anyway, Philip Seymour Hoffman.